firstly, let's make the obvious point. The humanitarian impulse is strong. I can understand why Rachel Maslow is trying to do this from a humanitarian perspective. It's something all of us, kind of inherently the heartstrings are pulled. But there is a slight problem here. I think, you know, and it was detailed in your conversation with her. We started off by putting the 5- and 9-year-old front and center. And of course, everyone's going to go, yes, children, not a problem. And that's quite clear. 5- and 9-year-olds, not an issue. What if it's 17-year-old who's been taken up arms in Gaza, who's actually been working for Hamas? There's no way of really working that out.
Well,
what if it is then?
They wouldn't be allowed in, would they?
But how would you necessarily know, Ian? Here's the problem. There's a second situation as well, which is husbands and wives. We're dealing with adults at this point. Again, who knows what we're importing into this country? And equally, and I'm by no means casting any aspersions on her constituent, but, you know, are we really sure that even the people who've here are not extremists in that kind of sense? We don't know. So part of the problem really is it's a security nightmare. It's very different to Ukraine, where there was no security threat. Let's not forget Hamas is a prescribed terrorist organization in this country. And if we are bringing people in where there is a doubt, this is clearly a security concern. Now, again, I'm not saying that young children are a problem here, but it gets much muddier further up the chain.
But presumably, look, I'm not a border officer. I don't know what procedures they have to vet people. But in circumstances like this, presumably they wouldn't just be letting anybody in. There would have to be checks made on anybody that was allowed in.
Well, one would hope. But then again, have we not seen people who have come to this country legally turn out to be extremists? I'm afraid we have, haven't we? So there's a question mark, isn't there, about how well those checks can be done?
That's kind of an argument for not letting anybody in ever, because there might be a risk that the odd person would slip through the net.
Well, not anyone ever, but let's think about various places where there might be more extremism rather than less. I mean, one would make the argument again using the three. Look, we've had Hong Kong, we've had Ukraine. There are examples of places where extremism is going to be far less likely than a place where, and you quoted the figure yourself, where the percentage of Hamas supporters is so strong. There's an obvious difference in terms of the location as to what sort of extremism we might be letting in.
Would you be comfortable if this scheme was just restricted to, say, children under the age of 16?
Yes, I think that would be a much more sustainable position and much simpler position to be taking.